so we just leave it there. Amen. We invite you to be here, Father. You promise that wherever two or three are gathered together in your name, you will be in our midst. So we know, Father, it's in your presence that we sing. It is in your presence that we say our words. May you be glorified. May your name be lifted up. When I walked through the doors, I sensed his presence. And I knew this was a place where love abounds. For this is a temple Jehovah God abides here. For we are standing in his presence.
Patriot fans.
should not mention I'm from Indianapolis. But I want you to feel at home, okay? And I don't really have to tell you that because you already do, right? Some audiences, you know, I have to kind of warm them up a little bit. Tell them to... But not you guys. You're I want you to clap if you feel like it. I want you to stomp your feet if you feel like it. I want you to say an amen or hallelujah or whatever you like. I just want you to... Or that's good. I want you, if you feel like singing along with me tonight, most of you feel free. You know who you are. You're the ones who make a joyful noise. But we are here tonight to celebrate because God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Would you please welcome my band? Good to see ya. Steve just got back from a little trip to Italy. Bless his heart. But it's good to see ya. Haven't seen you for a while. It's always good to see you. Well, tonight is going to be filled with music, of course. And I'm going to share some songs that I grew up with, like some of those great hymns. I'm going to share some newer songs that maybe you've not heard before. I'm going to go back into the old Sandi Patty archive. I'm singing for you tonight. I know we're probably not going to get to every song that you may want to hear, but we'll try to hit the most requested songs. And I just want you to sit back and relax and help me tonight, if you will. As I was putting together this particular record called Hymns of Faith and Songs of Inspiration, I got to go back to my childhood a little bit because my dad was a minister of music and my mother was the church pianist. And so all of my growing up, we went to church and we sat in the front row every Sunday morning, every Sunday night, every Wednesday night. I think we went to church about 8 days a week. But those wonderful hymns that I learned as a child have really become my heritage as a child of God. My dad would be leading the singing from, you know, up right about here. And my mother's piano, it was right down here on the floor. And it was turned such that she could see my dad, but she could also keep an eye on me and my two younger brothers who were sitting there on the front row. And then we'd get to kind of cutting up, and she'd get down to the lower register of the keyboard, and she'd just snap her fingers at us, and we'd go right back to playing. It was just really amazing how she would do that. But I learned to love those great hymns, and they were my inspiration for that record, Hymns of Faith. But I always like to run things by a dear friend of mine, Bill Gaither, who lives near me. And what? Well, I'm not dropping names. I mean, you think some kind of name dropping when I do that. I don't mean it to be that way. It kind of bothers me, really, when people drop names. You know, like that. George Bush and I were talking about that. But Bill said, now Sandy, I see all these great hymns, but I don't see any Southern gospel on here. He said, Bill, I don't do Southern gospel. You do Southern gospel. Your audiences love Southern gospel, but Bill, I don't know if my audiences are going to like that Southern gospel thing. He said, trust me, Sandy, people everywhere, even Medford, Massachusetts, love Southern gospel.
Yes,
is that true? Right?
Amen.
Well, here are a few songs that Bill suggested. And I have to admit, I'm kind of liking them. So if you happen to know some of them, you just jump in and sing with me. Precious memories. Unseen angels sent from somewhere to my soul. How they linger, I like them. Ever near me, every sacred past unfold. Precious memories, try it
again. Precious memories.
How they linger.
How they linger.
do you remember the old Carol Burnett show when she'd kind of come out ahead of time? Maybe some of you aren't that old enough. I don't know. But, and she'd field questions from the audience. Could you turn the house lights up just a little bit? I just didn't know if there was anybody that had... how can I get out there? Is there any way? Or is that... go that way and then through that way? Okay, well, let's see. If you'll turn the house lights up... and you'll play a little. Thank you.
Count to the balcony!
vou ficar aqui, deixa eu ver se eu quero ouvir falar.
All right,
now different times during this song, I'm gonna point to your side. is my friend Carolyn. Can everybody say hi, Carolyn? Could you play a little music so nobody knows what we're doing? This is my beautiful, beautiful friend who travels with me some, but she's really my friend more. And, you know, she's gone through some hard times, and she's single now. And, but you know, I just gotta say, she's got a very mature attitude about it. She says she's just waiting for God's will. So, Will, if you're here tonight, thank you, Carolyn.
Run.
She used to be my friend. Okay, I really need a drink of water here. Can you give me a little drink of water music or something? Well, we do live in a blender these days. Blended family. Like I said, I had four when we got married. My husband had three, and then 6 months after we got married, we adopted our youngest one. And we've been married now 11 years this year. And yay. And I'm just curious. I'm starting to ask this everywhere I go because I'm really amazed that I'm not the only one who has a blended situation. And if you are in a blended family, or you have been in a blended family, or in some way a blended family touches your life in one way or another, let me just hear your hands. It's a wonderful thing for me. I love knowing that and how God, He's always in the business of reframing things for us. You know, in 1995, the world was shocked when we heard that the Morrell building in Oklahoma City had been bombed. It was a terrible, senseless tragedy. And while that building was completely demolished, there were other losses around the perimeter of that, one being the First United Methodist Church there in Oklahoma City. They not only lost their building, but a beautiful stained glass window that had stood for many centuries. As the dust settled there, many of the parishioners came and they began to pick up the broken bits and the shattered shards from that stained glass window. And over the next few years, they took those broken pieces and they began to fashion them into new creations, some new works of art. Today, that church has been rebuilt, and there's a new stained glass window, where the old one used to be. But in the center of that new window is one single piece of the original stained glass that had remained unbroken, and it was the face of Jesus. And around that stained glass window are these words: He takes our broken pieces, and by His love, He makes us whole. I love that. That is the story of my life. As God has taken the broken pieces of abuse and divorce, sinful choices, and by His love, He has taken those broken pieces and He has fashioned them into new things, because He is the God of new beginnings. He's the God of second chances. Amen. Third chances, fourth chances. He's the God who sets His children free. And I remember one Sunday morning as I sat on the back row of the balcony, hearing my pastor say, God has not forgotten you, no matter where you are. Maybe you're like me, and maybe you're not literally on the back row, but maybe you're in the back row of the balcony of your life, and you don't know which way to turn. I want you to know tonight, has not forgotten you. He knows right where you are, and he knows right what you need. He's the God of second chances for you, the God of new beginnings for you. Just as he cares for the birds of the air and the lilies of the field, he cares even more for you. Also precious. greatest story ever told. It begins with Jesus walking down the way of sorrows, the Via Dolorosa. Down the Via Dolorosa, in Jerusalem that day. The soldiers tried to clear that narrow street, but the crowd pressed in to see this man condemned to die on Calvary. He was bleeding from a beating. There were stripes upon him.
A world of loss. What a beast.
wonderful way, and I thank you so much for that.
I love you.
And I love you too. God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
Well, I don't know if you're like me, but I can get a little discouraged when I look at the news, and there's a lot of things about our world that aren't real great right now. But you know what? We can't get so immersed in the bad stuff that we forget that there are some wonderful things about our world. There are teachers, doctors, and stay-at-home moms in this community, and so many others who are making a difference in their world. We gotta just keep being there for each other, bringing out the best in each other, standing with each other. And I know that this is an area that speaks a lot of different languages. I grew up in California. You know, all over our globe, there are just so many languages, but there is one language that will always remain the same. It's that language from heart to heart. Sing it with me. Love in any way, strength from the Lord, calls us all together, never apart. And once we learn to speak, once we learn to speak it, all the world will hear. Love in any language, live in this world. I want you to sing that again for me, will you? Love.
Yes.
This is my father's world. God bless you all.